Michael Collins, born October 31st, 1930, is an American former astronaut who flew Apollo 11 command module Columbia around the moon while his crewmates Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin made the first ever crewed landing on the surface. He was a test pilot and major general in the U.S. Air Force Reserves. Selected as part of the third group of 14 astronauts in 1963, he flew into space twice. His first spaceflight was on Gemini 10, in which he and command pilot John Young performed orbital rendezvous with two different spacecraft and undertook two extravehicular activities, EVAs, also known as spacewalks. He is one of 24 people who have flown to the moon, which he orbited 30 times. He was the fourth person and third American to perform a spacewalk. The first person to have performed more than one spacewalk, and after Young, who flew the command module on Apollo 10, the second person to orbit the moon alone. Prior to becoming an astronaut, he graduated from the United States Military Academy, and from there he joined the United States Air Force and flew F-86 Sabre fighters at Chambly-Bouzières Air Base, France. He was accepted into the U.S. Air Force Experimental Flight Test Pilot School at Edwards Air Force Base in 1960. He unsuccessfully applied for the second astronaut group, but was accepted for the third. After retiring from NASA in 1970, Collins took a job in the Department of State as Assistant Secretary of State for Public Affairs. A year later, he became the director of the National Air and Space Museum, when he stepped down to become the Undersecretary of the Smithsonian Institution. In 1980, he took a job as Vice President of LTV Aerospace. Collins resigned in 1985 to start his own consulting firm. Collins was born on October 31st, 1930, in Rome, Italy. He was the second son of James Lawton Collins, a career U.S. Army officer who was the U.S. military attaché there from 1928 to 1932, and Virginia Stewart. Collins had an older brother, James Lawton Collins Jr., and two older sisters, Virginia and Agnes. For the first 17 years of his life, Collins lived in many places as the Army posted his father to different locations: Rome, Oklahoma, Governor's Island, New York, Fort Hoyle near Baltimore, Maryland, Fort Hayes near Columbus, Ohio, Puerto Rico, San Antonio, Texas, and Alexandria, Virginia. He took his first plane ride in Puerto Rico aboard a Grumman Widgeon. The pilot allowed him to fly it for a portion of the flight. He wanted to fly again, but since World War II started soon after, he was unable. Collins studied for 2 years in the Accademia del Perpetuo Soccorro. After the United States entered World War II, the family moved to Washington, D.C., where Collins attended St. Albans School and graduated in 1948. His mother wanted him to enter the diplomatic service, but he decided to follow his father, two uncles, brother, and cousin into the armed services. He received an appointment to the United States Military Academy at West Point, from which his father and his older brother had graduated in 1907 and 1939, respectively. He graduated on June 3, 1952, with a Bachelor of Science degree in Military Science, finishing 185th of 527 cadets in the class, which included future fellow astronaut Ed White. Collins' decision to join the United States Air Force, USAF, was motivated by both the wonder of what the next 50 years might bring in aeronautics and to avoid accusations of nepotism had he joined the Army, where his brother was already a colonel, his father had reached the rank of Major General, and his uncle, General J. Lawton Collins, was the Chief of Staff of the United States Army. The Air Force Academy was in its initial construction phase and would not graduate its first class for several years. In the interim, graduates of the Military Academy were eligible for Air Force commissions. Promotion was slower in the Air Force than in the Army, due to the large number of young officers who had been commissioned and promoted during World War II. Collins Hans commenced basic flight training in the T-6 Texan at Columbus Air Force Base in Columbus, Mississippi in August 1952, then moved on to San Marcos Air Force Base in Texas to learn instrument and formation flying, and finally to James Connolly Air Force Base in Waco, Texas for training in jet aircraft. Flying came easily to him, and unlike many of his colleagues, he had little fear of failure. He was awarded his wings on completion of the course at Waco, and in September 1953, he was chosen for advanced day fighter training at Nellis Air Force Base, Nevada, flying F-86 Sabres. The training was dangerous. 11 people were killed in accidents during the 22 weeks he was there. This was followed by an assignment in January 1954 to the 21st Fighter Bomber Wing at George Air Force Base, California, where he learned ground attack and nuclear weapons delivery techniques in the F-86. He moved with the 21st when it was relocated to Chaumont-Cematois Air Base, France, in December 1954. He won first prize in a 1956 gunnery competition. During a NATO exercise that year, he was forced to eject from an F-86 after a fire started aft of the cockpit. Collins met his future wife, Patricia Mary Finnegan, from Boston, Massachusetts, in an officer's mess. A graduate from Emmanuel College, where she majored in English, she was a social worker, dealing mainly with single mothers. To see more of the world, she was working for the Air Force Service Club. After getting engaged, they had to overcome a difference in religion. Collins was nominally Episcopalian, while Finnegan came from a staunchly Roman Catholic family. After seeking permission to marry from Finnegan's father and delaying their wedding when Collins was redeployed to West Germany during the 1956 Hungarian Revolution, they married in 1957. They had a daughter, actress Kate Collins, in 1959, a second daughter, Anne, in 1961, and a son, Michael, in 1963.